Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Astrological Intentions. I'm your host, Alex Reavy, and with me here in the Jazz Fest studio is the magical marvel herself, Sandy Reavy.
Hi, Alex. Hi, everyone.
It is episode 83 and February 24th. Happy Monday. Let's get right into it. We have February 24th, Sun sextile Mars.
Believe and achieve.
February 25th, Sun conjunct Mercury retrograde.
Clear intuition, Kazemi.
February 26th, Mercury retrograde, sextile Mars.
It's okay. Tweak.
February 28th, Venus square Pluto.
Check into your love life.
And Mercury retrograde, sextile Uranus.
Do it now.
Then we have some talisman times that Sandy has finished up to make a successful group arrangement, to connect others for inspiration and healing, as well as some very special ones upcoming to include important relationships as family members, to bring loved ones together, and to allow the flow of all good things. Then on the horizon, we have March is a full jam-packed month with full of online and some local events, as well as our favorite journey to Bali and a couple new events you want to keep up with. Then in our house, we are going to talk about Mercury retrograde snafus and our favorite Mercury retrograde tips. So stay tuned for this episode of Astrological Intentions.
You got the keys. You got the keys. You got the keys. You got the keys.
Hello, hello. Happy Monday, everybody.
Hi, Alex. How are you?
I'm well.
You got a birthday coming up.
I do. I'm so excited to talk about that next week. So going direct, we have a message from Claudia, and she says, love the podcast and talked about it on all of my trips and retreats this year. And I mean it. I learned so much, and the weekly podcast is my favorite thing.
Oh, thank you, Claudia.
That's really nice.
I think this is Claudia from Germany.
Yes.
And thank you. I can say that we're worldwide.
Absolutely. I love that. So, of course, everybody send in your feedback. We love to share it with everyone. We love to keep this conversation rolling.
And where you're from. Where are you listening from?
Yes. So in the transits, let's get into this lovely week. Monday, February 24th, today, if you're listening on time, Sun sextile Mars.
So at 8:06 p.m., of course, we're Chicago time. This is what I call believe and achieve. I always like using those two words together.
That is our tagline.
It is our tagline. Mm-hmm. But here, this is just great for exerting high energy. It's like moving your body. It's physical action. Sun is our primary essence in a sextile. It's a 60 degree to Mars. So this is about exerting physical energy. So work in groups, be a team player. You'll gain satisfaction by working in is a group. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, take matters into your own hands. So kind of say you're in charge of something. You have a directive energy to do this. So believe in yourself and achieve what you say you're going to do.
As a team. That.
Yeah.
Okay. And Tuesday, February 25th, Sun conjunct Mercury retrograde.
Now, let's also say it's Mardi Gras and, you know, Fat Tuesday.
Mm-hmm.
but this is the Kazemi mark, which happens at 7:45 p.m., right around the 6 to 7 degree Pisces time period. And this is clear intuition. Now, when Mercury is in its retrograde cycle, it goes across the sun and burns, right? And this is what is the alchemical process of this Kazemi retrograde. It gets burned, anything that it's connected or collected over the times, because it's going into the heat of the sun, gets burned off. And that's why it's this clear intuition. And it just means that it's in the heart of the sun.
And you just did a webinar. You and Susan Goodell just did a webinar on Mercury retrograde. And this one that we're going through is Mercury retrograde in Pisces. But I will mention in our house how people can sign up for that webinar still.
Yeah, because it's just as a recording on our website, that thing we call on the website. Yeah.
Yes.
So this Kazemi period is from 4:19 p.m. on Tuesday, the 25th, all the way through 11:04 p.m. So this is, you know, it actually needs to be in with this 17 minute of arc, which doesn't mean 17 minutes on a clock. Mm-hmm. So it's to be very clear, concise, and understanding on a subtle level. Now those birthdays will be February 25th and February 26th. Those, anyone having a birthday, which means the sun is at that 6 degree mark, 7 degree mark of Pisces. This is for them specifically to really come in clarity, write things down today, be journaling, even if you're not a journaler, be one today, because the information that you can gather by just nonsense writing, right? It's coming from somewhere. Your arm is connected to your shoulder, is connected to your head, and it's connected to your brain. Is that a song? Or did I got that wrong?
It's kind of a song, but I think you kind of created your own thing there.
But, right, you see my point that, you know, just start writing, something will show up on the paper.
You don't have to have this, like, inspiration is what you're saying. It comes through the fluid motion of just continuously writing.
Get a pen, or get a telephone and hit the voice recorder and start talking.
Cool.
Yeah.
So Wednesday, February 26th, Mercury retrograde sextile Mars.
So the first time that Mercury on its direct motion was in a sextile to Mars in Sagittarius, which is a mutable sign. Then it retrogrades and hits this Mars while Mars is in the next sign, which is Capricorn, and that's a cardinal sign. And then the last time, this April 18th, it hits it in a sextile in a fixed sign. So it's like, be certain of your move by this April 18th with whatever's coming in around now. That will be your last time that these two meet up. And you'll be certain of your direction. It's like almost stop talking, stop reconsidering, and get moving.
Okay, that's a quick transition. So when you say it's okay, tweak. So we're kind of adjusting a little bit with the direction, with the action plan.
Right. It's like if you had let's use a bow and arrow, because I don't like the alternative word, bow and arrow, and you think you're going in that direction, you know, and you're aiming and you're squinting your eyes and making sure, right? Mm-hmm. This is like, slightly, don't let it go yet, right? Like, you're in the position of which way am I going to, what direction?
And
I
think we're monitoring that path. If an adjustment needs to happen, that's all right.
In fact, that's good. It's a good time to tweak it. That's why I called it tweak.
Okay.
Yeah. So not twerk. I didn't call it that.
Right.
Because that is not okay.
So Friday, February 28th, Venus square Pluto.
This was my cautious day. You know, I was putting together my favorite days and my astrological crazy, like this doesn't happen very often. First of all, none of these ever happen very often, but in the signs that they're meeting up in, but the ones that are like astrologically rare for our lifetime, I mentioned as well, but this is just a cautious day. This is Venus square Pluto, like you said. This happens at 4:08 p.m., and it's really checking into your love life. It's a 90-degree angle. So it gives you the opportunity, is that the right word? Let me scratch my chin and say, gives you tension. Okay. Which is opportunity. It's growth in order to readjust the fit. And do you and your mate puzzle up? You know what I mean by that, Al?
I think so. I believe so. But no puzzle piece is going to be perfect, right? In the whole grand scheme of relationships.
But your mold might have changed, right? But like before, this puzzle piece fit into this puzzle piece, right? Mm-hmm. And it fit, right? Because that's why you're together.
Right.
And now things might have gotten warped or whatever, and they may not, they might be buckling or separating somehow. It's just a really good time to look at that and readjust the fit. Now, one of my plans, oh, I can't believe this. Because I didn't bring my phone, remember? I'm like, did I have my phone? Well, there's an alarm going off wherever my phone is right now for me to have played a song on the way in for you, because this is where you were going to cue it. Because I was like, it reminds me of the Pink song. We're okay. Not broken. We are just bent.
Yes. Right? I think everyone knows that song. Right, that's a very popular song.
But that this is not a time to quit necessarily. It's because we're just bent.
Right.
And it's like, we're not broken. We don't need to quit this, but we need to see how our puzzle pieces can fit into each other. What needs to occur.
Right. And Seeing that, like, maybe the rigid pieces that were there before don't need to be so rigid. They could be a little bit more forgiving and a little less, you know, because to try and move and adjust something that's so rigid, it will become broken. But if you can make it malleable and easy and flexible, that's where you can bend instead of break.
Correct. And then, and actually next week, there's something coming in with the Venus square Saturn, because, you know, Venus is moving in this direction. Of course, Saturn and Pluto are very close in the sky together. We just had that conjunction about a month ago. So now Venus is going to meet up in the square to both of them about 7 days apart. So that leads to this Friday, the 28th, you get to continue talking and arranging, coming up with some new solutions over this period of about 5 days. But we'll talk about that next week.
Okay. And so Friday, February 28th, Mercury retrograde sextile Uranus.
Right. So this happens at 9:13 p.m., a couple hours after that, you know, checking in to your love life. But I titled it Do This Now. This is the second pass of three. This came in February 5th. And at that time, I asked you to write some insights, you know, because that Uranus can give you brilliant, inventive thoughts.
Right.
And now it's in retrograde. I don't want you to look at what you've written yet on that date. So I know hopefully you dated that in your journal or in your paper, February 5th, whatever you wrote. But just keep writing. And you don't have to relate it to know what you were doing. Just keep writing. You know, amazing conversations may be coming up with yourself that may stun you when you are permitted to read. And you want to know what day you can read that?
Yes.
March 22nd.
Okay.
That's the last and final pass of this Mercury now is moving forward and sextiling to the Uranus. So it's like, what was I thinking about for the last, you know, 7 weeks? It's time to look. A lot of insight coming in right now, folks.
A lot.
Yeah.
And a lot of analyzing too. Okay. And now for talisman times. So you have finished two talismans, the first one being to make a successful group arrangement. Tell me a little bit about what this group arrangement looks like.
So on Sunday, February 23rd at 7:57 a.m., and I'm, of course, was in Naples, Florida, visiting my son with my mom and my nephew, that the moon was coming right up over the horizon at that exact moment. And Venus and Jupiter were in a really nice, really tight square. So they were just in aspect. It's okay, the square. Jupiter likes squares. This is a balsamic moon. This is to make a successful group arrangement. My friends and I are on track to plan and construct a peaceful, healing, and financially stable environment. We are serious about this.
I could see some people building a wellness center or something together, or a retreat center. Costa Rica is my vision on that one.
Yeah, we have, you know, it is a day chart because the sun has just come up over the horizon with the moon. We can't see the moon because it's balsamic phase. So it's doing something in that healing entity, right?
Yes. So, okay. So the next one you have finished is Monday, February 24th, today,
this morning. Yeah.
To connect with others for inspiration and healing.
That was at 7:16 a.m. And this was a lot of sun and moon. This is a new moon in Pisces. Pisces is rising. Of course, the sun is in Pisces. And the moon is moving into a conjunction with Neptune, which is the the modern ruler of Pisces, and it's also sextile the traditional ruler, Jupiter. So this is a really beautiful position to connect with others for inspiration and healing. We see and understand this vision in order to benefit everyone that is included. All involved healing. All involved is healing along this process.
And so even when you say about like the modern ruler and the ancient ruler, I feel that those two planets are kind of bridging the ancient wisdom to the modern day wisdom as well. So there's that communication that they're speaking in the same, you know, language, and they can be brought together somehow.
Mm-hmm. Because old is new and new is old, kind of that feeling. But at the time when astrology was first being used, you know, over 2,000 years ago, Saturn was the last planet that you could see in the sky with your naked eye. And it wasn't until the 1700s, 1800s, and even 1900s. In fact, you know, I don't know, Pluto just had his 90th birthday.
Just 90. Wow.
Like a week ago.
So and, young.
And so the fact that these three last planets haven't been discovered until the last 300 years. So then they got assigned a sign that mm-hmm. was already being used from the ancient astrologers.
So right, because there are 12 signs and 7 ancient planets.
And there's a lot of astrologers, me included, that use both the traditional and the modern rulers.
Okay. And so the upcoming talismans that you have one February 26th, Wednesday, to include important relationships as family members.
Yeah. So this is at 9:54 p.m. This is Naples time. I'll still be there. And this is Libra rising with Venus in the seventh house, in relationships, with the moon applying to it. And all of this is moving in an aspect to Jupiter. So, yeah, to include important relationships as family members. I see my special loved ones as my family. I welcome them and treat them with love and care.
Yeah, that's beautiful.
You know, it's kind of like your extended family, so to speak. You know, we have some of those.
Yeah,
right?
Your family by choice. we know those people. You know, I got some of my girlfriends that are my sisters. Some of my, my chosen family members, my adopted family members, mm-hmm. my Chicago family members. Mm-hmm. So Thursday, February 27th, to bring loved ones together.
This is a really interesting.
So this is where we're going to take our family members, our adopted family members, and bring them in together for a party.
So this is at, 2:20 a.m. And this is coming in a couple days. I will still be in Naples, Florida at the time. And this is when the moon is in its second lunar mansion, and it's about reuniting people. And when I say reuniting people, this is a placement of somebody you haven't seen in a long time.
Okay.
So this is that intention of seeing someone that you haven't seen for a long time. And maybe for some strange reason you had to leave, they had to leave. I don't know if there was, you know, some negative situation, but this is a very powerful talisman. And it's bring loved ones together. I set my aim on our reunion. This return to each other is written in the stars. Hello again.
Oh, I really, really love that one. And that has such, without even saying the word, it has such a beautiful theme. And that theme is forgiveness. Because what's more important from the past is this present moment, is what we can do with this future. Mm-hmm. And if those align, that's beautiful. Mm-hmm. And I welcome you back and hello again.
And right. And we don't even know what, you know, I can't wait to see who is going to use this as their personal mm-hmm. talisman, because this means that they're setting their aim on a reunion. And this could be somebody that's literally lost, someone that's lost. You know, we see that MIA people, that like this is reuniting loved ones. So This is way deep. This is probably one of my like riveting, one of my heartfelt talismans I'll be making this week.
Beautiful. Mm-hmm.
And it's at 2:20 in the morning. So it's like this early,
very early,
dark, you know,
the brink of day.
Yeah.
So Friday, February 28th, to allow the flow of all good things.
So this is when the moon is in the third lunar mansion.
And so you've been speaking a lot about lunar mansions. Can you give us just a synopsis of this new...
Well, in ancient times, the fact that the moon has to be involved in all astrological talisman, all astrological magic, so that moon is the reflector that brings things to Earth.
Okay.
And so by watching the moon moving around the zodiac, we have to, any electional astrologer has to watch it, bringing it down to Earth, like bringing it into form.
Mm-hmm.
And when it goes through these lunar mansions, and that they each 10 degrees of a lunar mansion has a particular set of auspicious energy.
It has its own like meaning. Its own.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. And back in the day, you know, 2000-ish years ago, when they were making talisman, they pretty much paid attention. That was one of the main things, is watching the lunar mansions. So every once in a while, I'll see a chart looking really great, mm-hmm. and wanting to pay attention to, oh my gosh, this is in the lunar mansion of the third lunar mansion, which is at 7 degrees. It's the 7 degrees of Taurus, which is highly positive. It's a very constructive, nurturing. It actually protects travelers, but it's considered the little ones. So yeah, they're all different.
Okay.
Yeah,
that's interesting. I was just curious what those meant. So mm-hmm. continue on to allow the flow of all good things.
I request the positive gifts of divine bounty. I hold out my hands to receive this desired fortune.
Ooh, yes. And it is that feeling of...
nurturing, you know, highly positive, being gifted something
of value.
Fortune. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So on the horizon, we have March 1st through 8th. This is the online summit that we had an episode we recorded for you all with Bettina Gordon. And she is the never too late, you know, speaker out there, just teaching everyday people that you don't have an expiration date, that every single morning that you wake up and you are breathing, this is a gift. This is a gift from God. This is a chance to recreate your life.
Mm-hmm.
And so, of course, all of these events that we're going to be talking about, their links are going to be in the description. So if you guys just pop over,
and
look over.
That's free. And
oh,
she
right.
has 22 speakers from around the world that all have a different spin based on their authority on why it's never too late and why we are not our mother's mother's mother.
Mm-hmm.
And that our daughters like you won't even be your mother, right? You get to set new ranges and new goals and new expectations. So it's never too late. And
yes.
So catch mine. I think I'm the first day. I think I'm March 1st.
You are March 1st.
Yeah.
And you
and
spoke on...
It's about ageism. And that I talk about the astrology scenarios of, you know, Saturn returns that happen for everybody at 29 and at 58. I talk about the Uranus oppositions, the quarters, the Neptune, some of the things
so
that
So like
occur.
The astrological cycles that come while we age. But also I think what was really interesting too is that you got to share your own personal, you know, exploration and
yeah.
your reinventing of yourself throughout your mm-hmm. life.
Yeah.
And that's
this is
really
my third career at age 63. Yeah.
Yeah. And it's
beautiful.
I
don't know if it's my last. Let's see.
Yes. It's it's not. It's never too late. So of
Thanks
course
for the idea.
That link has been updated. So if you've been trying to click that one, the website is back on track and we would love for you to check that out. So March 7th and 8th, we are going to be in Northlake, Illinois. That is around the Chicagoland area. And that is for the Body, Mind, Spirit Expo, a really wonderful event if you are just curious about some metaphysical things. It is really, I think, like $12 or $14. It's easy. It's accessible. There's tons of vendors who will love to talk to you and teach you all about their...
And actually, each vendor has the opportunity to have a 50-minute lecture. And they have about 7 lectures going on every hour. And mine, if you want to know...
Of course.
...is Saturday at 11 o'clock. And so in one of the separate rooms, I'll be teaching Astrology 101.
Beautiful.
But don't forget the weekend before. You skip that. Because I'm going to Milwaukee, Body, Mind, Spirit. And that's the week before. That's the February 29, March 1st. And I know that's your birthday, so you're not going.
Right.
I won't see you guys there. It's not even in your calendar. but that's also that same Body, Mind, Spirit. They run about, I don't know, maybe 20 of them around the country. This is the one in Milwaukee. It's a really small but lovely people. Love these people. And I was not able to be there last year. So I teach on Sunday at 10 a.m.
All right. Yeah. And then we have our second Chatting with the Stars webinar. These are our astrology webinars. They start at $20, and this is a spring equinox and Saturn in Aquarius. You don't have to understand what any of that is. If it intrigues you, this is a really wonderful way for you to learn more. That's March 11th. And of course, you can head to intentionbeads.com/CWS, and that's CWS for Chatting with the Stars.
Right, and that's always the second Wednesday evening at 5:30 to 6:30 Central Time.
The Mercury Retrograde one went so well. And really, hardly any Mercury retrograde snafus in doing that.
Well, we were still in a shadow. It hadn't retrograded yet.
And so,
but our first one went super well. I'd say half the people that were there have signed up for the next one. And Saturn in Aquarius, you know, Saturn is the ancient ruler of Aquarius. It is moving out of Capricorn, where it also rules, but it's where... It's Saturn in Aquarius is more about community and about other people. It's about, you know, this group consciousness. Mm-hmm. It's going to be dipping in the end of March for a couple months. It retrogrades back into Capricorn, finishes up some work there, and don't we need work there? And then finally moving in December into Aquarius for a two plus year visit. So find out where it is in your chart. Find out what it means. This is a big shift in energy, folks. So shift with it.
Yes, I like it. Shift with it.
Shift with it.
So March 14th, we also have another online webinar. This is a talisman ceremony that Sandy will be hosting, and it's all about Uranus and Taurus. This is breaking up the stale, the solid things to create new. And we love this webinar. This is going to be the last time we're running it because Uranus will be...
No, what are you
saying? Oh, it's not the last time.
I'm probably running it for 7 years. I ran it last year. So this will be... I'll have 5 years after this.
Well, I stand corrected.
Well, Uranus is the planet of disruption, chaos, lightning bolt, complete awareness, awakening, rebellious, like all of those, mm-hmm. those good right. and bad, right? But through unexpected endeavors and it moving into permanently into the sign of Taurus a year ago really gave us like Taurus is the bull. It's the earth fixed, does not want to move.
Right.
And Uranus is saying, yeah, got to. So it will... if you're holding on to a ledge with your fingers, you will need to let go. Or do you want your nails really to come out on the windowsill? So your choice, because you're moving with a change and change is good. Staying in that old protective shield of I'm hiding because I got hurt. It creates more of a vulnerability. And don't we need that for newness in our lives? So come join that. That is, I will be making talismans. This is $188, but I give you worksheets.
Yes, it's much more personalized.
Way more personalized. And I'm making a clay bead while we're on the Zoom call. It's about a 2-hour Zoom call. It's at 4:30 in the afternoon. We'll be finished by 6:30. And then I'll be mailing you your talisman that has this, this awakening energy that you've set into motion. So really these talisman ceremonies, I'm trying to find more and more of them to do on Zoom so that, that my peeps can join me, setting intentions. So this is the next big one.
Okay. That's awesome. And March 18th, we have, this is a little special insert that I have here. Sandy is beginning some late readings to her
late night
readings. So this is an opportunity for, you know, people on the West Coast to get a little bit later in their day. However, we're pretty much already booked,
for this
March one. However, it will be happening once a month. Also, in here, I'm going to be offering all of you podcast listeners $20 discount on a reading with Sandy.
Wow, good.
So if
Where was that in our notes?
It's right here in my notes. You just can't see it.
Oh, that's a touche. I get it.
So if you head over to intentionbeads.com and... or click the link in the description and head to your astrology reading. If you type in Jazz Fuzz, that's JazzFuzz, then you will get your $20 discount from our podcast.
Ta-da!
Ta-da! Okay,
but it'll be the third Wednesday of every month that I'm running readings from till 9 o'clock. So the last sign up is 8 p.m. That is Chicago time. And I do think my first night is booked. And then I'm actually not doing any in April. That's Bali.
But right.
I'll be doing some in March. Yeah.
Okay. And so March 28th, we have the CWS, the Chatting with the Stars, quarter two. This is a free event. It's all online. It's on Facebook as well as Instagram Live. And this is a chance for you to see Sandy and Susan in their... pretty much like in their domains, because we have a very Capricorn woman and a very Piscean woman, and they're going through their astrological choices of the quarter. So you got 3 months there. Then next, we are jumping over to April. That's where we have our Toronto Yoga Conference. So anyone in Canada, we would love to see you there. April 20th to the 30th, we still have a couple spots left for our journey to Bali. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and actually for a lot of people who have joined us, it is once-in-a-seven-six-time opportunity.
It's the second time in a year that you're going.
So this journey to Bali is transformational. There is something about Bali that just calls you there, and you feel... so present, so alive, so carefree.
Simple.
So simple.
Life is so easy.
Yes. So it's always a great reminder to, when you go on vacation, not just to drink mimosas or Bloody Marys and stay by a beach, but really to involve yourself and engulf yourself into a new culture that has such zest for life.
And the self-awareness of the astrology.
Right.
All the teachings there.
Absolutely.
Right. Are you going to talk about the Tampa or not yet?
Yes, let's jump over to May. May 2nd and 3rd, we are going to be at the Hay House Conference. This is Hay House Live. So everyone's heard of the publishing house Hay House. A lot of Louise Hay is the one that started it. We absolutely love this community, because this community is already doing the work. They know what's up. They are just coming to touch point back with their speakers, their vendors, creators.
Their speakers are like my friend Clint Baron Reed will be there speaking.
Greg Braden,
Joe Dispenza, your friend Dr. Joe Dispenza, Gabby Bernstein, Matt Kahn. I mean, check out the link, and there are some early bird special deals you can get right now.
Yes.
But that's Hay House Tampa.
Yeah, check it out.
May
we would love to see you there.
And three. And I want to bring up NORWAC, which is the Seattle Astrological Conference that they have every year. I think, I don't even know what 20-something Laura Nalbandian runs. That's May 22nd through the 25th. I will be there. It is my absolute favorite astrology conference. And I'll be vending, but man, I am hanging. They're almost sold out. That's why I wanted to mention it is that Memorial Day weekend. But this is where you can really belly up to very amazing astrologers because they don't hold more than 300-ish, 350
And they're
maybe
very
people.
Accessible.
Mm-hmm. Very accessible. Yeah, you can sit at the bar and have a drink if you want to go in that room or right. dinner, or sit next to them at dinner. Anyway, N-O-R-W-A-K. No.
C. W-A-C.
N-O-R-W-A-C is their website. Okay.
Okay, so that is a wrap on all of our events that we have coming up. Of course, we would love to have you there. Make sure to check out all of those links. In our house, Sandy and I are going to talk about Mercury in retrograde snafus.
Well, here's my... So here's, I guess, one of the tips is when Mercury is going retrograde and you're looking at the clock going, oh my gosh, I only have 2 hours. Oh my gosh, I only have 1 hour and 55 minutes. And there was one thing that I thought I didn't do, but maybe I thought I did do, and that was to book our Bali pre-retreat.
Okay, right, yeah.
So that, you know, anybody that wants to come early, particularly us, anybody wants to come early can get their land legs, settle in, right?
Yes.
But my point of this Mercury retrograde, so that you don't roll your eyes because I tell too long of a story, is that I'm like, I'm pretty sure I booked that. And I looked at my calendar. No, I always write things down that I book and I didn't write it there. And I go back to the place that I wanted to stay that I had saved in my Airbnbs.
Right.
It's not available anymore.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. So I now had to start a whole new search. It took me 3 hours. So now I'm like tea times minus an hour of Mercury's already in retrograde. And I'm like frustrated. It took me 3 hours to find a possible place that would fit us all
right.
in the situation that I like because I have a particular...
You have a particular aesthetic. You have standards.
I have standards and, you know, I need to have a certain ambiance feeling. I'm a Pisces. I need to have
right.
a feeling of certain thing. I also have my Venus in Taurus. It's very important for me to have beautiful things around me. So I'm like, okay, and I'm chatting with the other person in Bali and I'm asking questions. He's answering them. And I go ahead and I book it and pay for it, right? And now I'm looking for the next thing that we have to do in the Airbnb world, right? Because we use Airbnb a lot. And I, all of a sudden, up comes this confirmation, which I had already checked. I'd already checked this area. And it says, you're confirmed April this to April that, and you're confirmed here April this to April that, the same time frame.
Uh-oh.
I'm like, oh my God, what did I just do? So I go relook at all of the emails and it had been missing from my Airbnb like trips, my
right.
registered.
Your upcoming trips.
It didn't show up there. It was in my emails.
Uh-oh.
So I had to cancel. That was me that had ordered it 3 weeks
earlier. That's why
earlier.
It was unavailable.
That's why it's not available because it was me. So now I,
that's
anyway,
a snafu.
And you know how cautious I am with
right.
how I make arrangements and things. And now I have to pay some stupid fee.
Booking fees. And
that I don't get back.
The non-refundable
and I'm like,
ones.
I'm mad at myself. I'm never going to tell Alex. I'm not going to tell anybody, but I'm just telling Aaron over here.
And
me and you, Aaron, I made a snafu mistake.
Right. Now in all of our podcast listeners.
What?
They're listening?
Is it more another Mercury?
Are you listening? This is a really great time to just say, hey, make sure that you guys, I would actually I would like to hear throughout this Mercury retrograde, if you guys have any stories like snafus that you want to talk about, please send those over because that would
it's
be really.
It's stuff. It's like just, it's, you know, just took 3 hours out of my and extra money off of my plan. So yeah, let us know. They're the little stupidest, you know, makes you feel stupid.
Aww.
But anyway,
no.
it was,
yeah.
I got something else I want to talk about.
Oh, okay.
So I rarely turn on the television.
Okay.
But I had but every time I do, every time I'm like, I need to turn the TV on right now. It's a message for me, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, okay, go over to the TV, turn it on. And whether I'm brushing my teeth or I don't know what I'm doing. And I'm listening. And the next story always has a message for me. And as soon as I hear that one story, I turn the TV off. So the TV's on for like 5 minutes.
Right.
Here's the story.
Okay.
Did I tell you?
No.
So the silverback ape, which is an endangered species, just had a baby. There was a mating thing that was going on over there. Uh-huh. And then a little bit later, a baby's born. And it's the first baby like born in captivity in years.
Oh, wow.
And they wouldn't let anybody see, in the public, see the baby. And they didn't announce the name until today.
Okay.
And the name is Angela.
Okay.
Which they're saying is hope for this species, because now they have hope that the species can continue even though it's endangered.
Right.
Because it's too hard to get the things to work so babies come, right? But here's the thing.
Okay.
So they asked us, and remember, Mercury's in retrograde. They made this little like segue to, hey, you guys, one of the reasons why this silverback ape is endangered is because it uses a mineral called coltan that is used in all of our cell phones. And when we recycle, hold your cell phone longer, not like hold it up in the air or anything, hold on to it. Like, don't keep replacing your cell phone as often as maybe you do. And this is just another retrograde, Mercury retrograde cell phone. Recycle your old cell phones to help allow this silverback ape to reproduce.
Because interesting.
It's taking
that.
These,
that seems like so, like, not like there's no correlation there, but of course there is.
There is.
Right. Wow.
So if you're not using more of this coltan and putting it back in as a incorrect form, you can help these animals. And I don't know if it's just this animal or all the jungles.
Wow.
But just interesting.
Very interesting.
So hold on to your cell phones.
We can add that to our favorite Mercury retrograde tips. So first one is recycle your phones. Recycle your communication devices. Mm-hmm. Okay? So you should already be doing that, but if you're not, do that.
Yeah. Save an ape.
And so also in Mercury retrograde, it's a really wonderful time. So I wanted to give my top five of Mercury retrograde things. So clean up and organize your email inbox. I know it's daunting, but like also unsubscribe from a lot of those emails, except for mine. You're not allowed to do that. So just unsubscribe from the ones that wind up going to the spam box anyway. And so, yeah, that's number one. Number two, finish a book that you've had on your shelf for far too long. I mean, we have 22 days. You can do this. You can finish a book.
And then recycle it. Give it back to the library. Put it in one of those little boxes that are on the
I love those little boxes.
In front of somebody's house. Look, I thought it was a bird box for a while, and it's a book box.
A bird box.
Well, I didn't know.
A bird house?
Oh, yeah, bird
but,
house
yeah,
thing.
But it's kind of like a bird box. Maybe that's where they got that Netflix movie from. So number three, set one clear boundary within like a personal boundary and reinforce it throughout the next, you know, Mercury retrograde. Because this is about rethinking
Until
the way
March
that you
10th.
Do things.
March 10th is when it retrogrades. When it stations to direct.
Right. And maybe we might be good and we have gotten our practice on those things so far. Number four, solve a problem with your technology that has been really bothering you. And everyone can think of something off the top of their head. For me, the way that like Google Drive is syncing up with my computer, I have two different streams. And so it just gets very weird and strange sometimes where documents are coming in and out. So that's mine.
Well, mine is just to understand that. I have no clue what that even means.
Well, it's cloud based. So that's the technology issue that, you know, people are having now because we're not saving things to just one hard drive. We're saving it on the cloud. Okay, so number five, return to a healing practice that has helped you in the past that you have not had enough time for.
Yeah, that's awesome.
And I think that that's a really one wonderful one to rethink about. And
that's probably your, your Kundalini practice, right?
Yeah.
I mean, I used to hear you in the...
Right. I mean,
the breath of fire.
The breath work is pretty amazing, and it is transformative. So, but yeah, I think that's my top five Mercury retrograde tips. However, we also have the Mercury retrograde webinar that Sandy and Susan have recorded, and it's now available for download. This is a $20 offer. It's super easy. It's wonderful information where you can actually understand what is Mercury retrograde and what are people talking about.
Yeah, we show slides. We show it in the sky. It's not really retrograding, but why does it call that? We're showing all that. And actually, they're still able to add $5 to their cart, and I give them a chart.
A personal
chart.
Showing
where that Mercury retrograde stops in their chart, what house it's in, because we give them tips on what to work on during that Mercury retrograde, going through your fifth house, your sixth house, or your ninth house, and we show that on your personal chart.
Right, where you can get a personalized idea of this theme.
Well,
for
you need the chart, and it helps to have your chart in front so that you can correlate it to your personal life while you attend the already recorded Zoom call.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. And that is all for our episode today. Many, many thanks, gratitude for all of you guys listening in on this podcast. We love doing this. It's so nice for us to sit across from each other and just enjoy the conversations.
Mustard. Yeah.
So, of course, if you have any questions for me or us, info@intentionbeads.com or private message us on Instagram.
Tell us your Mercury retrograde stories.
Yes, we'd love to hear from you. Until next time, we'll see you next week.
Adios.